Today we are going to study the stress and strain in the composite materials. So before that, we should know about the composite materials. What is meant by composite materials? The materials which is made up of more than one materials, that is known as the composite bar. These bar are joined in such a manner that the load taken by both the materials should remain same. So in that case, the elongations or contracts of the bar should be constant or it equally elongated. So you may say that the when the bar is subjected to tension or compression, its extension or contractions remains same or you may say equal. So while solving the numericals of that composite bars, we should understand or we should remember that things. One first is extension or contraction of the bar should remains constant. It means delta Ls is equal to delta L another materials, or you may say deformations of one bar is equal to deformations of another bar. Second, the total external load on the bar is equal to the sum of the load carried by the material 1 plus the load carried by the material 2. So we may concentrate on that figures. In that figures, two bars are given, first and second bars, both are hinged at upper end and at lower side load P is acting. So in that case, total load is carried, that is the P, that is carried P. L is the length of the bar L1, L2 is the length of the bar at 2. A1 and A2 is the cross sectional area of the bar A1 and A2 respectively. E1 and E2 are the modulus of elasticity of the materials 1 and 2 respectively. So how to apply these principles here while solving the numericals for composite structure? In these numericals we are going to calculate the stresses in each bar. Similarly, we may calculate the elongations of that each bar and total load carried by each bar. So, see numerical number first. Reinforced concrete circular section of 50,000 mm square cross sectional area carries 6 reinforcing bar whose total area is 500 mm square. Find the safe load the column can carry if the concrete is to be stressed more than 3.5 MPa. Take modular ratio for the steel and concrete as 18. Now here, what is meant by modular ratio? Modular ratio, it is the ratio of two different materials of modulus of elasticity. Just here steel and concrete. So ES upon EC, that is equal to 18. Now let's note down the given data for that. Area of the concrete bar, it is given area AC is equal to, you may say, area of column, that is given 50,000 mm square, area of steel 500 mm square. So total area of that column, it is 50,000, we may say column, and it having the bar, so that is area of steel, it is also given 500 mm square. Now net area of the column, area of concrete, we may say, that is AC is equal to, you may calculate, total area is given to you, 50,000 minus 500, you will get the area of concrete. Now, according to that, our Hooke's law. Hooke's law state that modulus of elasticity is equal to stress upon strain. So we have seen here stress is equal to stress upon strain. So strain is equal to, you may say, sigma upon modulus of elasticity. So this is a composite material. So first we have to consider that strain in steel bar is equal to strain in concrete materials. So according to this we may write the equation sigma s upon es is equal to sigma c upon ec. So sigma s es is equal to, you may say, ES upon EC into sigma C. So sigma S is equal to ES upon EC, that is a modular ratio, it is given 18. Concrete strength is given, stress, that is 3.5. So steel 63 into Newton per mm square. Now safe load in the column, our second condition, total load carried by steel plus load carried by concrete. So total load P is equal to PS plus PC, means load is divided into these two. Total load carried by the column is equal to load carried by the steel plus load carried by the concrete. So here we will see equations again. Stress is equal to, you know, P upon A. So P is equal to, you may write, sigma into A. So according to this, sigma S into AS plus sigma C into AC. Sigma S is known, we already calculated 63. Steel area is also known. Sigma C is also known. Area of concrete we already calculated. So total load carried by this 204750 Newton, or you may write 204.75 kilonewton. Okay, now come to the second points. Second numerical, same numerical, instead of here only change the area. Reinforce concrete column 500 mm by 500 mm in section is reinforced with a 4 steel bar of 25 mm diameter, one in each corner. The column is carrying a load of 1000 kilonewton. Find the stresses in the concrete and steel bar. Capital E for the steel 210 GPa and for concrete that is 14 gigapascal. So note down that given data, area of concrete is directly given 500 into 500. So 25,000. Number of bars are 4, 25 mm diameter, so total area 4 into pi by 4 into d square. Total load carried by the column is 1000 kilonewton. Convert into newton, 1000 into 10 raised to power 3. ES is equal to 210 gigapascal and concrete 14 gigapascal. Now, area of column it is given size 500 by 500, so this becomes 25,000 mm square. Number of steel bar, that is 4. So area of steel bar, total area 4 into pi by 4 into diameter is given 25 bracket square. So area is 1963 mm square. Therefore, area of concrete is equal to 25,000 minus 1963. So it becomes 248,037. Strain in steel is equal to strain in concrete. So sigma s upon es is equal to sigma c upon EC. So therefore sigma s is equal to ES upon EC into sigma c. Sigma s is given 210 GPa. If you say here 10 raised to 3 will be cancelled. So that will be cancelled into sigma C. So that relations you will get here, sigma S is equal to 1.5 sigma C. Say equation number 1. Now our second principle, total load is equal to load carried by steel plus load carried by concrete. So here we may say again sigma s into as plus sigma c into ac. So sigma s we may write here 1.5 sigma c from the equation number 1 into area of steel we already calculated, plus sigma c into area of concrete 248,037. So unknown our P, total load is, P is given, that is 100, convert into newton, 100 into 10 raised to 3, 1000 into 10 raised to 3 newton, 1.5 sigma c into area of steel 1963 plus sigma c into 248.037. here unknown quantity is only sigma c, so you will get the value of sigma c. that is 3.6 into 10 raised to 3.6 Newton per mm square. Put this value in equation number 1, you will get here sigma s is equal to 1.5 into 3.6, so it becomes 54 Newton per mm square. Now come to our next equation, that is third numerical. A load of 270 kilonewton is carried by a short column 250 by 250 mm in the size. The column is reinforced with 8 bars of 16 mm diameter. Find the stresses in concrete and steel. If the modulus of elasticity for steel is 18 times that of concrete, that is a modular ratio. If the stress in the concrete is not to exceed 5 MPa, find the area of steel required so that the column may carry a load of 500 kilonewtons. Note this. A load of 270 kilonewton is carried, so total load is carried, that is total load is equal to 270 kilonewton. In this numerical there are two cases. In first case we have to calculate the load by considering 270 kilonewton. But in second case again load is given 500 kilonewton and stress is also given. So we have to consider here two cases. So in first case we may say load on the column, that is P is equal to 270 kilonewton. So convert into 270 into 10 raised to 3 newton. Area of column, size is given 250 mm by 250 mm, so it becomes 62500 mm square. Area of steel, 8 bars are there and diameter of each bar is 16 mm, so pi by 4 into 16 into number of bars 8, so that area becomes 1608 mm square. So area of concrete AC is equal to area of column minus area of steel. So 62500 minus area of steel 1608. So that area becomes 60892 mm square. Now according to that, again apply our first principle, that is strain in steel bar is equal to strain in concrete. Same principle we have to use, sigma s upon es is equal to sigma c upon ec. So therefore sigma s is equal to es upon AC into sigma C. So that is 18 into sigma C. So therefore we may say sigma S is equal to 18 sigma C. Equation 1. So total load P is equal to, again we say steel plus concrete, load carried by steel plus load carried by concrete. So again total load is given 270 into 10 raised to 3. You may write sigma S into AS plus sigma C into AC. So here sigma S from the equation 1 we may put 18 into sigma C. Area of steel we know 1608 plus sigma C into concrete area 60892 we already calculated. So you will get here sigma C is equal to 3 newton per mm square. Similarly calculate the sigma S. Sigma S is equal to 18 into 3, so it becomes 54 newton per mm square. That is our first answer. Case 2. In case 2, area of steel required so that column can carry the load of 500 kilonewton. Now here we have to calculate the area for steel to withstand the load of 500 kilonewton. So we may say new area, that is AS1, area of steel required and new area, that is concrete area AC1, area of concrete. So you may say area of column minus area of new steel. So total load, again total load P is equal to, we may say PS plus new concrete, that is PC. So in that case total load is, we have to, condition is given, load should be sustained, that is 500 into 10 raised to power 3. We may write here sigma S into AS1, now here that is new area, plus sigma C into, that is also new area AC1. So 18 sigma C, that equation we already derived in the first case, that remains constant, AS1 plus sigma C into area 62500 minus AS1. So in that case 18 sigma C is given, 5 condition is already given, stress should not be exceed beyond that 5 megapascal into AS1 plus 5 in bracket 62500 minus AS1. So solve that bracket, 90 AS1 plus 312.5 into 10 raised to 3 minus 5 AS1. So it becomes 312.5 into 10 raised to 3 minus 85 AS1. And this equal to 500 into 10 raised to 3. So in that case, you will get the area. AS1 is unknown quantity, that is 2206 mm square. This is our second answer. Now come to our fourth numerical. Read this numerical. Block as shown in figure weighing 35 kN is supported by the three wires. The outer two wires are of steel having the area 100 mm square each, whereas the middle wire of aluminium and has an area 200 mm square. If the elastic moduli of steel and aluminium are 200 GPa and 80 GPa respectively, then calculate the stresses in the aluminium and steel wire. Now in that case, there are the three bars, two bars made from the steel which having the equal length, and another third bar which is intermediate bar that is made from the aluminium, and at the bottom 35 kN load is acting. So in that case, deformation in all the, these three bar remains constant, and we may say the total load is equal to load carried by the steel plus load carried by the aluminium. So total load P is equal to 35 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. In that case, if I say here that this diagram, this one is the steel bar, in this side intermediate bar is aluminium bar, this steel, this also steel, this also aluminium, and total load is P 35 into 10 raised to 3. So in that case, load is, that is PS, this PS, and another is P aluminium. So in that case, our equations become P is equal to load carried by steel plus load carried by aluminium. Total area of steel, there are two bars, this bar number one, this bar two. So total area, so here multiply by 2 into 100 mm area square of each bar is given. So total area becomes 200 mm square. Area of aluminium, that is also given, 200 mm square. Modulus of elasticity, ES is given 200 GPa. Aluminium is given 80 GPa. So here length is same, so we may say deformations of the steel bar is equal to deformations of the aluminium bar. So delta L, So we know the equations delta L is equal to PL upon AE. But P upon A is equal to, we may write sigma L upon E. We may write that equation in this manner. So delta L is equal to sigma L upon E. So in the same line of action, so we may write the equation for steel, sigma S into LS divided by ES is equal to sigma aluminium into L aluminium upon EL. Now in that case, length of the steel bar and length of aluminium bar remains constant, so LL will be cancelled and our equation becomes sigma S upon ES is equal to sigma EL upon EAL. So sigma S is equal to ES upon EAL into sigma AL. So sigma S is equal to 200 GPa divided by 80 GPa. If you multiply by 10 raised to 3 will be cancelled. So here we may get the relation sigma S is equal to 2.5 sigma AL. Equation number one. Now our second principle, that is total load. P is equal to load carried by steel plus load carried by aluminium. Same equations we have to use here. Sigma S into AS plus sigma aluminium into A aluminium. So put here 2.5 into sigma AL into AS plus sigma aluminium into area aluminium. Put all this value. Total load is given 35 into 10 raised to 3. 2.5 into sigma AL is unknown. Area of steel is known, that is 200 plus sigma AL into 200. So unknown quantity is sigma AL. So sigma AL is equal to, you will get 50 newton per mm square. And sigma S is equal to 2.5 into 50. So again you will get 125 newton per mm square. I hope you understood all that four numericals. If you have any doubt, you may ask me. Write in the chat box.